Greetings again, and welcome to Zendikar Rising Traditional Draft. Alright, nice pack. The uncommons are all quite nice, and then there is of course the Deadly Alliance being the best common in here. Of course the Scion and the War Leader are kind of dependent on other cards in your deck. I mean, not this so much, but this is a two-color card, so you would have to be basically red-white to pick this, and I wouldn't mind first picking this, nor the Scion even. You usually want to go, of course, black-white if you first pick the Scion, and the Windrider Wizard is a fine playable in any blue deck, but I think the pick still here has to be the Deadly Alliance. It is just an all-around good pick in here. It doesn't really matter what are you gonna draft, and of course this is just a better card than the Windrider Wizard. Now here we have Thundering Spark Mage into the Royal Vanquished Week, and of course the Relic Vile is very nice. Would be a perfect pick here if I had picked the black flying cleric in the first pack. I mean, this could still be the pick, but this kind of would require that clerics are mostly going to be open, so the safer choice might just be the Vanquished Week. I would rather take the Spark Mage if I already knew that I'm red-black party. This is a stronger card than the Vanquished Week, but this will keep my options open the best, and I think I choose that from this pack. I mean, you just can't go that wrong with picking a couple of removal spells, especially from the same color, and these are even splashable, so if I end up some other archetype, I might be able to splash these. Okay, so this is not going to be a black card anymore. The Demon's Disciple is just a quite bad card, in fact. Mind Rain is a fine playable, but of course not really a pick 3. And the options in here are mostly going to be like Fireblade Charger, maybe even Dauntless Survivor, or the Tazim Royal Mage. I think it's one of these three. And, well, I mean, this is not a exciting card, but I don't mind actually drafting black-green. I have had quite a bit of success, mostly when the black cards in the deck is, you know, this kind of removal. So you get to play green big creatures and black removal to stay in the game and finish with the big creatures. I think the Royal Mage still is the pick in here because I have two cards I'm willing to return with it. And here we go. There's the Veteran Adventurer. My weakness is this card. Whenever I see this, I want to pick it because, well, you can easily get this down on turn 4 if you are able to curve out 1-drop or 2-drop and then a 3-drop. And this will cost 4 if they are different creatures. I mean, different party creatures with different types. So let's see. Blue-black doesn't really have many things here going on for it than the Ghastly Gloomhunter, and it's not really that great. Yeah, I'm gonna take the Adventurer here. I could also take the Core Celebrant, but I have already passed two very synergistic cards for this, so I let it go and I'll pick the green card. Okay, there's no green in here, and yeah, I don't like this. I guess as a sideboard card, because this is a best of three draft, it might make some sense to take this for your sideboard. Yeah, I don't have really... I mean, I guess if I'm black-green, I might have a bunch of 4-drops and you know, and a bow. The other option is mostly the Ravage's Mace, I would think. I think, well, white is somewhat open, but yeah, I mean, you could take the Expedition Healer. Would have been pretty not ideal after passing so many white cards already. I think I'm gonna take this for a sideboard card. This can be useful sideboard card. I don't really see it playing it main deck though. Alright, so now it's a question between Nimana Skydancer and the Stonework Pack Beast. The Skydancer is fine, but nothing too amazing. I think the Pack Beast is just gonna be the more useful card in the end. I really don't know about my colors yet. So Chilling Trap for... Nah, I don't think so. I think the Akum Warrior is the best card in here. I'm passing another cleric here. I could have gotten a very nice cleric draft had I picked a Black Flyer in the first pack. Well, I'm gonna take the Akum Warrior. It's the most interesting card out of these choices. I have no idea what my colors are yet. And then there is gonna be the Ghastly Gloomhunter now. Yeah, pretty easy pick out of these. And There is something that allows me to play white too. The land could be the pick in here. I don't think the skitter sneak is that great of choice here. I'm gonna take this. This makes it easier to maybe. Also, if I don't end up playing black here after all, I can splash these. And if my deck has white, then the pathway will be a good way to splash these things. And here, a pretty weak pack. I think I'm gonna just take the Expedition Champion here. And now I got the Dauntless Survivor here, which I'm gonna pick in case I end up green. So this is quite a mess, but hey, that's what makes drafting interesting, because now I have a lot of options still to for my final deck. I'm not sure if I should. No, I'll take the Skitter Sneak here. I don't like to play this in decks that don't have ways to mill the opponent, but let's see. It's most likely going to be cut in the final build, but let's have it here for now. Okay, so both sideboard cards. I guess this is slightly better, and I do have the pathway to splash it. Well, I got the silencer. I put it to the sideboard. I just don't like that card that much. Alright. This is a strong pack. Baloth, Sephiroth. I'm sure many do like the Ruincrab too, but it's not my favorite. Into the Royal would be my pick over the Ruincrab here. Thwart the Grave is the best card here, I think. Yeah, it is. I'm gonna take it. Definitely better than the Baloth, even if I end up green black here. So yeah, pretty easy Thwart here. And that cements me to black pretty nicely, and I think. Okay, there is the Turn Timber Symbiosis. I suppose I pick it here. I might really go green-black. There's really not much. The blue wasn't open in the pack one, and I'm passing now this into the rules, apparently, but I mean, the Thwart the Grave is better a card than the Into the Royal, even in a blue-black deck, so that was easy to pass that thing. I mean, if I would want to go the Tazim Royal Mage way here, I could really pick the Into the Royal here, but I'm taking the Symbiosis. It's a nice one when you have the 7 mana. You can play this as a spell that should have a board impact, because even, I mean, actually you want to get a cheaper card, I mean the CMC 3 or less card, because those 3 counters really make a big difference. But yes, I'm going to take this, and I'm hope that the black-green will be open enough. Yeah, blue is now open to this direction, but it's no surprise, because I did pass quite a, I mean, I didn't pass that much blue, because I didn't get past blue either in pack 1. Okay, the Root Grazers are going here, but well, Rabbit Bite is an easy pick here, and yeah, these packs aren't greatest. Relic Axe is not great because, well, I have, no, actually I should lose my red cards, lose my blue card pathway. I just need to remember I have it. So yes, this would be like the card. I don't want to play the Skitter Sneak, but I might. Okay, so let's see. Relic Axe doesn't have more than one warrior plus one pack beast. I mean, it still might be the card I pick here. Black has no warriors though, so that's a pretty nasty. But I guess if I get a few more green warriors, I might be playing this. I don't think the pack is very strong. I didn't really see a reason to pick any other color of card. Now it's easy, pack beast. Definitely these colors are not very open to my direction, but the pack beast is a fine pick here, especially because I do have the Adventurer here and the Thwart the Grave makes cheaper. These both will be cheaper thanks to the pack beasts. And okay, this has some, okay, there are some options here. I mean, I could just take the sideboard card here. I always want to have this in my sideboard when I'm playing green. The Seagate Colossus might make some sense too. I have here a bit of party business going on, and the Roiling Regrowth, but currently I don't care about that card. I guess I'll take the Colossus. Okay, Mossbit Skeleton, that was a nice pickup. Although I really would have wanted to take the Visionaries. It's sad that these came in the same pack, but I mean, there's really no question that this is the pick here. Also, I need, well, okay, I guess I have a 2-drops here, so I don't need them that much, but anyway, this is also a 5-drop. Very nice one. Alright, so I'm not gonna splash anything, I don't think. I'm gonna just take the 20 gems here for a little bit additional value. Now this is exactly the kind of 3-drop I want to have here. It also makes the Relic Axe something I might play here. I also already have the Pack Beasts, Yeah, there's actually four cheap warriors in here already. Of course, this is a warrior, and this is a warrior, but I mean, the relic axe is more impressive when you have cheap creatures to equip with it and get the full bonus. Of course, everyone will get the plus one, but that's not so great. I have one of these silencers in my sideboard, but I guess I'll take another one because I don't want to play the two mana spell either. Well, let's take the third one then. How many creatures? Nine creatures, six other spells. I mean, I can play the Skitter Sneak just because it's a rogue and I have now already some payoffs for the. I mean, I have three spells that it's gonna make cheaper, so I think it makes sense. At least unless I get a bunch of other more, I mean, better four drops. And black, by the way, does have warriors. There's of course the four drop warrior that black has. Did I say that black doesn't have warriors earlier? I think I might have said something like that. But yeah, there's the 4-1, 4-3. That is a black warrior. Right, this pack. Whoa. What a pack. I mean, the Blood Priest is, of course, exactly the kind of card I want to have in here. As a. Well, it's just a very nice 2 drop when you have a bunch of different party creature types. I wouldn't mind picking up the 3 drop in here. And then. Well, I guess the bailout would be fine too. But now, of course, the decision is between the another adventurer and the crawling barons. I mean, this is a nice one, this barons, but it of course requires the game to go pretty late. I think in this case, because I know I'm going to play green, I'm gonna take the adventurer here. That's pretty weird, but I think that was the correct choice. Okay, the Skulker, I don't really need the 2-drop. I would like to have the creature type, but I think the Malakir Rebirth is just a better card in here, so let's take it. Okay, this is pretty nice. I mean, again, a ton of cards, and I want them all of them, but I'll take the Mass Pit Skeleton. It's just, especially if you have two of them, you can kind of, you know, recur them both. When you kick the other, you get to pick the other from your graveyard, put it on top of your deck. But yeah, there are a lot of good options. I would take, well, maybe not the Shadow Stinger, but I mean, both of these, Vanquish the Weak and Malakir Blood Priest, also cards I would like to have, but I'm not going to gamble on the Moss Pit Skeleton coming back. I mean, it could, because if no one else is black-green, this might come back, but I didn't want to make that gamble. Right, and then we have like not much going on here. It's going to be the Subtle Strike or the Mind Drain. I mean, both are sideboard cards. I'm not gonna main deck either of those. Maybe. If the opponent is very aggressive. Okay, let's take the Subtle Strike for now. There is a Journey to Oblivion, which I could splash. Well, I mean, I guess I could splash if I took the. I took the 20 gems, this thing, when there was a Reclaim the Wastes as well in the same pack. So maybe it punishes me a bit that I didn't do that. I'm still gonna take it though. Over the Might of Murasa, which I'm not interested in playing. I might still blast this. Okay, well, you know what? Recurring three Moss Pit Skeletons is even better than two, so let's go deep with the Moss Pits. Alright, and then there's a Gloomhunter, Marauding Blight Priest. Do I want to have the creature type cleric? That would be my first. Given that I have no really three drops in here creatures, I'm picking it over the Gloomhunter. That's actually a pretty easy pick now. And the cleric creature type is going to make this expensive stuff cheaper here. And I need some creatures here still. Is there something in here? I mean, I can play the Journey to Oblivion. Okay, well, there's a 3-drop from me. For me. Yeah, nice. Pack 3, pick 8. Completely first pickable rare. But I mean, if no one is black green, then they are definitely not going to. Not going to pick it. Right, I'm gonna take the Sky Dancer. It flies, so maybe it's a bit more useful than to have another one of those clerics. And then, well, good that I picked a rogue because I have another 2-drop rogue. I have a lot of 2-drops, but then again, the Moss Pit. What? So this was the crazy pack, and I really got the Vanquish the Weak back from there. That was amazing. What was I saying? Yeah, these are mostly 5-drops in this deck because I have so many other 2-drops here, so I don't need to play them as a 2-drop quite often. I mean, potentially main deckable cards. could be the subtle strike. I mean, it's a trick, you could play it, but I think I don't have room for it. The Journey to Oblivion, now that I don't have any other way to splash it than the pathway. I mean, I do have a couple of pack beasts, but it's gonna be something I'm sideboarding in if I really need to have this effect available. Yeah, I don't have that many green cards here. Green wasn't open, but black green was. I got this Mosspit Skeletons and the Ravager here. But I mean, I'm still playing green here. I mean, I don't have more than like, well, there are 10 green cards here. The Mosspit Skeletons are green, so. I mean, this is pretty. I think the deck is here. I'm just gonna cut one swamp here. Oh, forest. Let me see. Let's cut all the basics now and put the MDFCs here. I don't have more than two of them. Right, but there are 16 basics in here, is completely fine. Let's put the Mosspit Skeletons to kind of, you know, 5-drop slot here. I'm going to play the Skitter Sneak. It's my only 4-drop, in fact. Let's see the curve here now. So, okay, creature curve is a lot of twos, but then again, a bunch of these are Mosspit Skeletons, which I have the option to play on turn 2, but also on turn 5. Yeah, the Shadow's Verdict will be very bad because I don't want to exile my Mosspit Skeletons. They will get exiled even if they're on the in the graveyard. Just checking out the creature curve here. No, it's fine. And these will be cheaper most of the time. How about these? I have a couple of pack beasts and then I have one cleric, three rogues, no wizards sadly, three warriors. Okay, so this will be like one or two mana cheaper quite often. I think I'm gonna play these, also the Seagate Colossus. I have not that much removal in here. And the Relic Axe, it's gonna boost, it's gonna give a full boost to how many guys? Warriors are three, although one of them is the Seagate Colossus, which I, well, I mean, yeah, then it will be 9-6 if that makes any difference. I don't think it's gonna be that relevant to equip the Colossus, but anyway, I have those two cheap warriors. I have the Dauntless Survivor and the Murasa Brute, and then of course these Pack Beasts will be 4-2s with this. And then the rest of the guys will get +1/+1. I'm gonna play the Axe here, I think. Because I'm not gonna play 17 basics. I'm gonna play 16 basics in here. And if I just want to cut the Axe, I would have to put something else in there. I guess the Subtle Strike is a playable card. You could have it, but I'm gonna sideboard it in against one toughness creatures. I'm not gonna main deck it. So I'm gonna add lands here now. And how even of a... I mean, this is a triple caster, because when I get to 7 mana, I do want to have three green sources available. So even though most of my deck is black cards, I don't need to double black that much in here. All I need is one black source. This is a double black, and this, when you kick it, is double black. That's it, basically. So I can actually play here an even mix here. Putting 16 basics in here with these MDFCs means that I put 8 of both, and that will give me 9 for both sources. I could play this pathway because there's really literally no cost, but there's no benefit either, other than some bluffing system. I mean, there is the one kicker card in the format, the artifact. 4 mana artifact creature, which is a 4/4. It has a kicker. When you kick it, it's 7 mana when you kick it, and it enters with additional +1/+1 counter for each non-basic lands your opponents control. So I think this is one of the few... That's one of the few reasons to not run this just for fun. I guess I'm not gonna play this now. Yep. So it's gonna be 8+8. All right. Yeah, the matchmaking takes a lot of time this late in the season, so you should definitely use the chapter selection there to skip straight to the next match. There's also a quite high chance that you will get paired against the same player when you finish a match and then you start searching for your next opponent. I think I'm gonna play the pack beast. There's a chance I'm gonna end up kicking this thing. Okay, that was aggressive. Don't mind him using that thing on my pack beast. Okay, well, let's do this. I mean, I have to block a rebirth if I for some reason want to have it. I don't think I'm gonna save this guy. I don't have any of my party payoffs in my hand. If I did, of course, I would in that case, save it. What does this mean? It's obvious that the opponent is going to trade here. There's no reason playing the Relic Axe pre-combat because it has Death Touch anyway. So I could play the Rebirth in here now, just not sure if I want to do that. I mean, I do have the Relic Axe for the next turn, so I guess I can do it. Hopefully they don't have a response here. I will lose the Rebirth for nothing then. Okay. And now I can play the axe here now too. That was the only reason, because I know, of course, 2-1 against their 5 drop wouldn't be doing much, but now that, well, that was sad. At least I can follow up with my own. Yeah, now that was they had the 5 toughness, 5 drop. I was kind of hoping they wouldn't have anything that big, so I could have attacked with this guy, but apparently. Let me see, I can equip this and make it a 6-6, but opponent is having something. I suppose I still play only the Sky Dancer here, so okay. That's a decent use of mana. They have only lands in their hand. Or maybe they're playing 3 colors here. That they had no plays on there at all. Turn 6, with 6 lands and 3 cards. Okay, they have something to return from here. Alright, so they play the full inscription in here. That's not ideal. I need to discard 2 cards in here, and they will kill this guy, and they get the Blight Blade back. So I'm gonna have to lose. I think it has to be there. Yeah, I want to keep the Gloomhunter. It's of course very risky because I don't necessarily draw the sixth land, but then again, then I draw something I can play. Most likely. I mean, I guess it could be the Seagate Colossus. That's probably one of my few cards that I couldn't be able to play. Okay, that's bad. I mean, I still have to use the. I mean, I have to take the Gloomhunter here. No blocks there. Hopefully, I just draw the untapped land here. Well, that is fine. I have a blocker for the Mossbit Skeleton now, and I think I'm not going to attack with the Pack Beast right now. I might get some party payoffs in here. Okay. Yeah, this can be. Yeah, that was just horrible there. I mean, of course, when you get to play this at full value, it's going to be bad. Do I even want to do that? They have. This thing will be very problematic too. But if I'm at 6, yeah, I have to do this. Yeah, I'm probably not gonna win here. Well, especially not now. Yeah, that inscription really made it all so bad. So they have Kazan the Stoneburner, they have this Mossbit Skeleton. I guess I'm gonna sideboard in the Smite the Monstrous and the Journey to Oblivion here. And now it's really, I mean, costing me that I picked this 20 gems. I just didn't really. Yeah, that was one of the. I don't mind drafting these 20 gems, but that was actually a point in the draft when I should have picked the Reclaim the Wastes. That had a realistic chance to getting played. And of course, 20 gems is. It's actually quite a small amount of gems, so that was me being too greedy. Usually, I think when I pick the rares, it's over cards that I really wasn't going to need. But in this case, if I had to reclaim the waste here, it would make the splash so much better here. But it is what it is. Because I'm gonna have to play now two. I do have the pack beast, so it's double the pack beast. It helps me making my, you know, splash happen, and also makes. I mean, now I will have less sources for green and black, but it will help in that case too. I'm gonna play two planes in here. So let's take these ones. That is still a total of, actually, because this is also a black plant, that's good. So that's gonna be still 9 black sources in here and 8 green sources thanks to these MDFCs. So it's not so bad. But I need to cut, of course, now there. Oh, wait a second. No, no, actually, I should. No, I of course need to cut a swamp from the pathway too. So that's gonna be 8 black sources. So, yeah, the cards I don't need in here are probably going to be something must go. Okay, the axe can go, and then I guess it's one of my two drops. Perhaps the survivor, now that I don't have the axe in here, I'd rather have the thing that might have death touch. Yeah, that's it. Well, let's go. So they have a 2-drop, and this is a turn 3 play, and this other Muspid skeleton will most likely be a turn 5 play. I don't see playing it as a 2-2 when I only am one land short of the 5 mana. I will start this with this Muspid skeleton instead, because if it trades with some of their 2-drop, I can get it back anyway. Won't be going to my hand, but okay, so yeah, you can. I don't need a second planes here. Of course now it will be a little bit tougher to get to that 5 mana, but I mean these spells will all be useful here. I don't want to lose them. I will draw lands here in this game eventually. Okay then. I wish I did discard that one. Well, on the other hand, this is a nice, nice draw, because I will have it. Well, it will still cost 5 mana. By the way, opponent has a lot of discard. Now if they fire up the, you know, the inscription, that would be pretty bad. Yeah, I'm not gonna trade my creature types, but I can trade my Muspid skeleton. Yeah, I want to fight off this thing while I have the chance. Okay, there's their skeleton. Well, that actually also needs a fifth land now. Don't have anything to return either, so very awkward to play this as a 2-2 now. I don't do that. Yeah, this was not ideal. Man, this discard. Both of these would be now useful. To kill the Muspid skeleton and get the fifth land here. Okay, I'm gonna trade that guy. Well, this can certainly be pretty awkward now. Okay, nice. 3 spells. Okay, well, now at least I got this thing. So I'm gonna play the Colossus now, of course, because I'm gonna get it back then in case. Although, oh, wait a second. The problem is that this will become cheaper, more expensive very soon, so because I'm gonna start trading with these guys. Yeah, I'm gonna play this now, and then I wouldn't want to be. Do I want to attack with this guy? Could trade with that. Let me see. Discount attack, I have the Colossus in here. This can, but I can take one damage. I will trade with the Mosbit Skeleton. Discount attack. Okay, I guess I can attack with this thing. Yeah. If they use a Blight Blade, I don't care. I mean, Blight Blade is gonna be annoying anyway. Okay, hopefully they don't have the inscription. If they have it, I'm just gonna lose. I've already discarded two cards in here, so if they can make me... Okay, they had their own thwart here. Oh man. Ah, oh, that's just disgusting. Let's... okay, discard ate me in that match. I mean, that game. Well, I guess the game one was bad too. At least I didn't get the same opponent now. Okay, that's a fine one. I am on the draw, so I would ideally have a 2-drop here. But I have a 3-drop, and then the Adventurer and the Thwart the Grave are, of course, very nice cards. Black Red Party. Okay, I'm gonna have to destroy that. I don't want to take the risk that... I mean, if I play this thing... Well, this will have death touch, so I'm gonna... Okay. I will take the damage anyway. But this is just safer to do like this. Then I can play the Brute, and then maybe the Adventurer would be able to happen on turn 5 with the Brute. If the Brute survives, that is. Okay, they didn't want to discard anything. That is, yeah, that's definitely something. Me missing the 2-drop here was very big. But I mean, I assume they have a removal now and then gonna attack me for, yeah, not having the 2-drop. But this is just so. This is the reason why you want to have the 2-drops available, because, I mean, this 1-2-2 they played on turn 2 while I had no play myself. That means that I. This has done so much damage in here. I should have played the Symbiosis, by the way. I should have played the Symbiosis here. Tapped, because now I would have to take 3 life loss there. Now, I'm not focusing on this game. I kind of seems like I gave up this now after him removing my Brute there. Okay, the opponents have... What's this? But because I have a lot of 2-drops here. 5, 6, 7... I have 8 2-drops, so not having that in there was the difference of quite a bit of damage. So do I just want to play the Shadow's Verdict in here? I think I want to play against that deck. But I don't have... this Skeletons will be so much worse now. Also my own Thwart the Graves will be worse, but... I mean, I can still have this expensive stuff happening here. So, what I'm going to cut here when I took the Subtle Strike... I guess the Relic Axe is always an easy cut here. And then I don't want to lose my cheap stuff. I guess the Nimana Skydancer is the least useful, because I will maybe be on the defensive so often. That I'd rather have my 2-drops, and I still want to have the 7-5 here. Well, there is no green source other than the Pack Beast, but I suppose I'm gonna still keep it. And I think I'm gonna want to have all my land drops thanks to these expensive guys. So the Veteran Adventurer in this current board state will be a 5 mana play. they kill this pack beast right away, that can be very bad if I don't draw the green. But I do have 9 sources for green. Okay, so they're digging for land perhaps in there. I know I'm not gonna lose the pack beast, I want to have this cheaper. I mean, I guess I have to twat the grave, but so far... Okay, so they... Alright. Well, I don't have the option to really kick it, so... If I get the green mana, I will just play the Veteran Adventurer instead. So let's see what they're gonna do. They didn't want to trade last turn, so let's see if they want to trade now. Yeah, can I draw the green source perhaps? 9 ways to get that green mana happen. Okay, so they get their Vial triggers, but not much I can do about that. No, I can't get. Well, that makes the Veteran Adventurer... Yeah, but I still need the green source, because this will get me green, but yeah, it's not enough now. At least the Colossus will now be playable if I draw a Swamp, so there is that. No, I just want to draw my Shadow's Verdict too. I mean, soon they can start using their Sneaking Guide there. Okay, I have a Death Touch. Well, I'm not gonna lose my creature types here, so yeah, let's do just this thing, whatever. The Reliquial is gonna get me. And they're gonna... This Sneaking Guide is gonna get me too. Okay, this starts to be a bit awkward. Yeah, I could get this back, but it doesn't really matter that much. Here I'm gonna do this thing. I'm going to give this Kalkar a counter, because this will be dropping... Oh, these are... Yeah, I'm gonna have to decline this, actually. I want to draw the green source. At least I have now... I can play both of these things. My hand is so reliant on me having these creature types in here that I can't even make that good blocks here. I mean, they're gonna... Okay, they didn't at least have the advantage the weak for the Skulker, so they're gonna just attack for 2 in here. And now I need to start raising them. It might be too late for me also, because they can... With the combination of the Skidder's Sneaking Guide and the Reliquial, it's gonna be pretty bad. I guess if I get to kill the cleric, then this won't, this life gain, life drain thing won't be happening. Anyway, what's the... I mean, I guess I want to play the Vigilant guy instead. Also, it needs the green mana, so if Pack Beast dies, I can't play it. So I'm going to play the Veteran Adventurer here right now. And I guess I do need to start... attacking with this Skulker in here. I do have 3 blockers anyway here. Yeah, I'm really losing to this Viala here, and the Sneaking Guide. Having the full party doesn't really even help me much. If I had a little faster, I mean, for example, I would have drawn one of my green sources, the Adventurer would have been a much earlier play here. Well, they are gonna deal 2 to me per turn, but... Well, we'll see. I get a 3 mana Colossus at least, that's fun. No, that's not more unblockables. That's not great at all. Well, I don't want to attack with the pack beast. It's my only green source here, so and I don't think it makes much sense to attack with the Dauntless Survivor here. I mean, I guess I could. This is having Vigilance anyway, so I guess one extra damage might make sense. Now, I could just, you know, play the Toward the Grave here. Unless if... I mean, yeah, I should have done that pre-com, but I didn't really think through. I mean, I could have just double-spelled here. That actually would have been great. I don't have time to, you know, return this on top of my deck here. But yeah, they didn't trade with the survivor, which is kind of understandable. Yeah, definitely this is the way to go here. So I'm gonna play this, and I'm going to play this. Oh, actually, cancel. I can't get two non-party creatures here. Okay, scratch that. Yeah, it's not a return two target creatures. It's basically always almost this. But I'm still losing to all this unblockable stuff and the reliquial. I do have a bunch of removal in the deck. Do vanquish the weaks, and I have a deadly alliance, rabbit bite, but and I also have the Shadow's Verdict here. But yeah, none of that mattered. I mean, they were finishing the game with 23 life. I don't think this deck is bad, but these matches have been just pretty awkward somehow. Yep, this is a 3 land, 2 drop and 3 mana spell. A couple of these payoffs. Although I don't have any party creature types yet here. This is the third match and I lost the previous two matches, which means there's nothing extra to win. But I'm of course still playing this and I want to see if this deck actually can function well. And I suppose it's good to show that not all of my drafts are... only successful ones, so I do have some bad drafts occasionally too. Now that I drew the forest, maybe there's like a very small chance I get to 7 mana in the end, so I'm actually gonna do this. There's also the possibility that if I want to play it as a land, that I don't get punished by it, because I mean, either the tree life has to matter or that I can play it just as a tapped land at some point. But now that I didn't draw another land, I'm more likely to. I'm glad I have removal for that thing. Well, now I did draw a land, so there's still a chance that the Symbiosis will be played as a spell. Next turn though, yeah, I don't have any that great stuff going on here. I would need a party creature type here. Okay, that's not a big deal. I can make this even a 3-3 with the axe. Do they have something else? Okay, well, I mean, with that land, I think I only need like one more green source, and then I need only one more whatever land, and then I can play the Symbiosis. I suppose I'm gonna leave the Symbiosis now. Well, I mean, depends on what I draw. Next turn, I might have no available place. But if I draw a land next turn, then that means I can play the Adventurer even without any discounts on turn 6, and opponent is not really erasing me that badly. Although I have to leave the Mossbit Skeleton to block if I don't draw a play here. Yep, no reason to race here. They're gonna gain life with this, and yeah, I'm just wanting to slow down a bit because my hand is quite high power hand, so there's no real reason to try to rush here. They can use removal or boost spells or whatever. I don't expect this trade to actually happen, but let's make them use mana for it. And if the trade happens, that's of course fantastic. I do wanna lose my 2/2 Mossbit Skeleton to get rid of their Kabira Outrider, and then I can even get this back. Yeah, that's what I'm saying. It's pretty sweet now that they had to use the 3 mana for it, and now I have the Adventurer here, so there's a higher chance that this won't get removed. And then next turn I can play either the Symbiosis or the Seagate Colossus, whichever I want to have. And I did in fact draw all the lands for the Symbiosis. Okay, so they have this enchantment based removal, and I don't have Broken Wings on my sideboard, which is pretty awkward, but whatever. Another Adventurer, but I guess I'm gonna just play the 7/5 now. They're gonna run out of, you know, removal at some point, I assume. Okay, I'm gonna play the Vigilant guy this turn, so I can make the attack here. It doesn't matter if I pay 6 or 5 for this thing. I didn't want to give them the additional information. Don't have anything in my graveyard, sadly. Oh, actually, that was the reason to... I completely forgot the Relic action there. Yeah, I should have done this pre-combat in case this Seagate Colossus would have died during combat. Well... okay. So now they're actually forced to block. What are they holding? If they have 3 cards and there's so much mana in there, I don't get it. Might of Murasa, perhaps? No. That's fine. And then I mean, this thing can whiff. This is gonna happen for sure, so... let's play the kick thing. And now if this dies, I can put it back on my top of my deck when I play this and get the counters, likely. Okay, so the big guy's now way enough. Yep, so I don't have ways to kill this enchantment, sadly. Ooze. Okay, that was the dangerous card, but I have 2 Vanquished Weaks, I have the Deadly Alliance, I have the Rabbit Bite. That has to be enough now. How about the Subtle Strike? White, green, I don't think it's necessarily that useful, so maybe I'll just... submit the same deck here. Okay. Well, I do have the Pack Beast for the black spell, so I mean, and I'm playing against green white, which well, it has the Kabira takedown though. But I could just, you know, draw one of my 9 black sources. Why wouldn't I draw one of my 9 black sources? So this will be just a 2-1 on their turn. I'm obviously not gonna make any blocks. If they now have a Kabira takedown and I don't draw the black source, then, well, I guess I deserve it. Right, well, there's now a more pressing matter here. That thing again, and this time I don't have the removal for it. Well, this thing has Death Touch now, so let's hope that they don't have a way to deal with the... I mean, maybe they don't see that it has Death Touch. Well, of course they do. If they can make an attack with the Ooze so that the Ooze will survive, I think the only chance I can have here is just... it's only going to be Deadly Alliance, but now they didn't have a way to... connect with the Ooze. They could have of course had the Nahiri's Binding too. Okay, that's now the black source there. So there is that. And I can kick this next, I mean not next turn necessarily, but when I get one more land. Because I could play the Skeleton and the Relic Axe, of course, but this makes a lot more sense. Makes also the Seagate Colossus cheaper. So I can actually cast it next turn. If all these guys will be surviving. And then this can actually block the ooze, even if it's a bigger one. Well, how about that? That is a lot of... Okay, that's just... I mean, the ooze now I was able to deal with, but this is just unfair. They have the blocker. I'm not gonna go for the axe this turn. I'm gonna have to play my 7-5 and hope they don't have land drops like ever. They can give counters to these guys and then this will give another counter when they all attack. Well, I mean they would all have to attack and I have a death touch blocker and 7-5, so it's not that great for them, but yeah, the Felidar Retreat is not exactly a fair card because it also gives a vigilance when you choose the counters. That's like a makes it impossible to race. But my out is that they don't have land drops. Well, they didn't have a land drop, at least not yet. So I have here 4 mana. I'm gonna play the Skitter Sneak and then the Rebirth tapped, most likely. I mean, they can block the Colossus so that it dies. That is a possibility. I can also just Relic Axe the Murasa Brute here and start. Yeah, I guess I'll have to just make the race here happen now. Yeah, I'm gonna deal 12 damage to them. And I have the Malakir Rebirth that I can also... Although with the Thwart the Grave, I don't think it makes that much sense. Maybe I just want to have the land here happen. That's also my second black saw, so I don't have to rely on the pack piece to get this thing happen. But if they're gonna like triple block that or something, or double block this thing, I'm gonna save my Colossus with the Rebirth in that case. That's too important to keep here. If they trade with the Brute, that is acceptable. I can actually just play the Rebirth and re-equip something else. Okay, that is great. 7 damage is enough to kill them both. And now I will survive. Make this thing survive so I can attack next turn as well. Now, it would be pretty funny if they play this on turn 4 and never get find another land in time. But I did kill 2 of their guys, so that means the counters are that much worse now. I'm happy they went for the double block. They don't have the land drop. That must feel so awkward for them. Yeah, I'm gonna take it. Oh, that must feel so awkward for them. I think this turn is just gonna see me play the Muspid Skeleton. Do I want to even... I think the Expedition Skulker still has to stay as a blocker in here. They might go for the double block on the Brute, but I mean, if I get rid of their ooze, that's just gonna be so bad for them. Yeah, this has dead touch, so I'm gonna leave it as a blocker. Bye-bye ooze. So now the counters are not as sick that would have been with the ooze, because the ooze would of course make more of... basically double the amount of counters, because it adds a counter to each attacking creature that has a +1/+1 counter. So I have one creature in here so far. Okay, they're gonna kill the skeleton and go for the race. No, they can't. They have to leave at least one blocker there. Okay, so this is 5 power they have. If I equip the axe, that means that they can't kill it. But if they are going to... Yeah, I mean, I have to thwart the grave here, so why would I care if they go for the double block? And now I can attack with my Death Toucher as well. Okay, they did play the Felidar Retreat and didn't have a land drop after that. That must be pretty awkward for them. Now it's too late. Alright, so now I can do so that I will equip someone. They will have to block the Colossus, and this is of course a lethal attack. I guess I'm gonna just attack with everyone and have to play the Mossbit skeleton there. No need to bother with the Relic Axe. Oh, well that's actually a sweet turn. They get two more guys, or alternatively one more guy and then counters on them both. But I suppose they're gonna go for the... Well, I don't know if they... Let's see. When did they draw this thing? That must have been a... They did play a land now. So they must have had... Oh, I don't actually know what's this. They must have had a land or the Rolling Regrowth on the previous turn as well. Well, there's still a lot of things. They have to block each of these, so not so easy for them. And this will actually get menace quite soon, and then it will require two blockers. I don't know about this. I mean, they played the land and this on the same turn. They didn't draw any extra cards, so they had one of them available earlier. Hmm. So these things both need to be blocked. And then when I equip these, they are all lethal now. And then I even have the ability to play the Skittersnik post-combat if they had something. Well, it wasn't an 0-3, but it was a 1-2. But I suppose this is a evidence that I do upload all my drafts, not only the ones where I go 2-1 or 3-0. So Kaldheim, there's a few more days till Kaldheim happens, so I'm gonna draft these Zendikar drafts and maybe a couple of Tinkerer's Cubes. And then it starts to be non-stop Kaldheim very soon. Thank you for watching, and I will see you next time. Bye-bye.